Since the dawn of time when the internet began...
This terminal is linked to a giant brain 10 miles away in the heart of London.
Humans have tried to understand it, and, well, we've mostly failed. Digital platforms are evolving and increasing so fast it's near impossible to keep on top of them all. The good news is, you don't have to.
What you probably do need to keep on top of, though, is your digital image. And I'm not just talking about hiding boozy pics from your boss on Facebook who you mistakenly friended in 2009 when everybody actually used Facebook. No, I'm talking about your actual image, your photo, the hundreds, possibly thousands of pictures and videos of you floating around in cyberspace.
Every day, more than 500 million photos are shared online. That's 500 million images of someone's boring holiday, lunch, pet, baby, workout, all posted on Facebook, Flickr, Photo Bucket, Instagram, Imgur, and the like. Technology's allowed us to share our most intimate moments with, well, everyone. In some cases, rather unfortunately so.
Has this man never heard of Snapchat? Your dong shots disappear seconds after you send them. I have been told.
Yes, there are ways to control who sees what, but it's a lot harder to control who shares what.
Real success has always been aided by sharing. That's where BuzzFeed can help.
Especially because there are sites, nay, businesses, dedicated entirely to sharing videos and photos of you.
Simon, can we single-handedly blame BuzzFeed for pictures going viral online?
I don't think so. I think pictures were going viral on the internet before BuzzFeed were in existence. We try and discover the most emotive, viral images we can, and people love sharing them.
And what makes a picture go viral? Is there a formula?
I think the main formula is it's got to have emotion. It's got to move people in one way or another. It's got to hit them in the tummy and make them think, I've really got to share this with someone.
Basically, if you post anything with children biting other children,
Charlie bit me.
Cats playing instruments. Cats not playing instruments. Or Americans interviewed on local news.
I said, oh Lord Jesus, it's a fire.
It'll get shared.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
Then someone will remix it. Then you become a viral internet sensation and millions of people will spend millions of hours procrastinating at work as a result.
Oh Lord Jesus, it's a toothache.
Meanwhile, you get to capitalise on just how much the internet loves you by flogging everything from dentists to dinner.
I ain't got time for that.
All because you now own a very valuable piece of copyright.
The long day of childhood calls for America's favourite pasta sauce.
So it's not surprising that people actually try and go viral. You get a profile and a paycheck. It's great. But is there a downside? Yeah, it's the internet.
One morning I was up before work and I noticed that I had a whole heap of hits on my blog and I thought, hang on a minute, I haven't blogged today, what's bringing them to my blog?
It was this picture. Carly had uploaded it onto her blog and it ended up on Reddit.
They were using that to ridicule my photos and a whole heap of commentary was underneath, like, I look like silly putty or, you know, I forgot to put my sunscreen on or I look like a lobster.
Carly has a skin condition called ichthyosis. That's what she blogs about.
At 7 o'clock in the morning, I would say there were around 3,000 hits. Once media outlets got hold of my story, I think it was like 40,000 on one day and maybe 37,000 on the next day. At one stage, I felt really unsafe when they were saying, oh yes, she lives in Melbourne or, you know, these are people, I don't even know where they live. You know, they don't have their faces to their names. They don't have their names on their accounts.
Okay, so what if you get into a situation where you put up a photograph for whatever reason and then it ends up in the WTF column in Reddit?
I think you're in trouble, really, unfortunately, because that is one of the most visited parts of Reddit and people love to see something that makes them like a sense of shock and awe.
So what happens now? Well, you can take legal action under copyright, privacy or defamation law, but the process is long, costly and often ineffective. You could issue takedown notices to every blogger, user and website that's wrongly used your image, but again, we're talking hundreds of thousands of people. Or you can fight the internet with the internet.
So the best way to deal with this is to educate them, not to keep going on, to keep making these diagnoses, to make these comments. And my photo had been used on Reddit and it's only through blogging that I'd gain the confidence not to feel devastated about this, because I realised, you know, these are only words and I feel, you know, really happy with my life, with the success that my writing has taken me, and that I have, you know, someone, a family and a man that loves me, and it wasn't so bad then.